The Aldonzo and Dee Show has a special message for the terrorist sleeper cells that are in the United States and currently crossing the southern border.
All right, you primitive screwheads, listen up. See this? This is my boomstick! It's a 12-gauge double-barreled Remington. S-Mart's top of the line. You can find this in the sporting goods department. That's right, this sweet baby was made in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Retails for about $109.95. It's got a walnut stock, cobalt blue steel, and a hair trigger. That's right, shop smart. Shop S-Mart. You got that?
Boogie!
Coming at you from the Skyhammer Studios here on Cities 92.9, this is the Aldonzo and Dee Show.
You have insanity in my earpiece.
And we're up in smoke as usual. I'm Aldonzo.
I'm Dees.
And we've got a lot of stuff to go over in this show for you on a beautiful Saturday morning. I bet it's going to be beautiful. What do you think, Dees?
No, it's not. It's going to be cold and crappy.
It's going to be cold and miserable. And you know what?
We got teased on Wednesday. I think it hit like 77, something like that.
I don't think it was 77.
It was 76 when I was on my way home from the doctor.
I'll tell you this much. I disagree that it was 76 here in the Noy, but it sure felt like it after the cold we went through. Of course, it's going to be.
AccuWeather said it was 70 friggin' six.
You mean in AccuWeather?
Whatever. It was 76. It was hot.
Stupid.
I almost turned the air on. Now it's ball chilling cold.
That should be a crime, what AccuWeather calls themselves AccuWeather, because it's, well, all this meteorology. BS, bull sticks. You know what else has really got old Aldonzo's ass chapped? I'm getting really tired of daylight savings time.
Yeah.
To the point to where even like the weeks coming into it, I start getting angry.
It's just like marriage. It's an old, outdated practice that just needs to go away.
Amen, brother. But no, seriously, this has really got me. I've never been so angry. And this year really hit me hard. I don't know why. But I was more angry about this than usual. Look, we get up early in the morning and go to work, right? You get up earlier than I do, I think.
Yeah, whether I want to or not.
Whether you want to or not. We've been through that, yep. And we'll ask about your week. But we get up early in the morning. It's dark. I don't care what, if you shift an hour or not, we get up in the dark. We get up and go to work at night, okay? Even in the summertime, we're up at dark. Now, what they've done is, I guess they did this for the farmers, this daylight savings time, where they would put an extra hour of light in the beginning of the day and take it away from the end of the day. But see, us working folk, and even farmers, well, they don't care about this, but us working folk, that hour you take away from the end of the day is 1 hour of daylight we get when we get off work to do stuff.
It made sense when they come up with the idea back before tractors had lights on them.
Exactly.
But now you drive around whether it's plant season, harvest season, whatever, they've got these big machines that have gigantic floodlights that make it look like daytime around them.
They go 24 hours a day.
It's long since past the time to abolish this savings time crap.
This is stupid, because I'm going to tell you what's it's psychologically, when you go to work at night and you get home at night,
it sucks.
It does. I've been doing this for years. I just don't like it, and it's just
the days are already shorter anyway because of the way that the sun rotates around this flat earth that we have.
don't I'm just you
kidding,
started
I'm
the
kidding.
Flat earth thing
I'm
man
kidding.
Do not get me worked
up. Yeah, they're short enough. And then the fact that we literally, during the worst time of the year, when everybody's already blah and depressed anyway, because it's just dreary and overcast and the S word is probably coming soon, we're already bummed about that. And now we literally have like 7 hours of actual daylight, most of which we're spending at work or driving to or from work.
If there was one thing, okay, that a liberal politician could say, That would make me go, you know what? I agree. You know, I'd almost vote for him if I didn't have so much of a brain in my head.
Haven't they voted on this multiple times to completely get rid of it?
But if somebody said, I'm going to end daylight savings time, I would be like, I'm not going to vote for this liberal, but he's got a good idea. Or maybe she or he or they or them or whatever their pronouns are, which we've got to get into that too. There's this new thing. I think it's Department of Health and Safety Service, whatever, is coming up where they're making it like you have to use these certain pronouns or they'll can you. We got that coming up. Real quick, I want to give a shout out to the sponsor for this, for the Aldonzo and D show, which is EnviroSeal. If you have sunken concrete slabs, patios, drivewalks, that was a joke, driveways, any kind of sunken concrete slab that's not quite level anymore, you know, you're tripping over it or it just looks bad, these guys will come in and use polyurethane spray foam insulation and plump up the slabs, and they'll get them jacked up and level for you, and you can use them the same day. And they also do commercial and residential spray foam insulation with that polyurethane foam too. So for all your jacking needs and insulation needs, give EnviroSeal a call at 309-275-6303. Deez, real quick.
Hold on.
Go
just,
ahead.
Just to the Sunshine Protection Act, which was what they called this thing to get rid of daylight savings time, was actually passed by the Senate last year, but voted down by the House of Idiots. And there is a current version of the bill that is just sitting idle there. Daylight savings time was started in 1918. Like, we barely had electricity then, so.
If there's one thing I would go back in time and change, it would be the person that came up with this. I'd hit him
like
over
I
the
said,
head
with
a
hammer.
Like
I said, it made sense back
yeah,
then.
Yeah, it did. It did, but that's okay. But you're right. Technological advancements. Let's cut this bull sticks out. Let's be done with this.
Yeah.
Stupid. I can't believe nobody has solved this. Anyway, we just put a whole chunk of the first segment on daylight savings time. But I'm sure a lot of the listeners out there agree with us, though.
I can't think of anybody. The only thing good about daylight savings time is when you're in your early 20s and you're out partying at the bar, and the bar would be like, well, extra hour to drink and try and take that 4 home that looks like an 8 right now because you're in the bag. But, yeah, other than that, it's time to
okay,
get
well, one thing we can say for certain that Aldonzo and D's aren't spring chickens anymore.
No.
And we're lucky to stay up till about 10 o'clock at night and get one extra drink in us.
I'd be glad to call myself an autumn chicken right now. But
fall chicken?
Yeah, fall chicken.
Speaking of falls, how was your week? Did you have any falls? Cats trip you up? My cats tripped me up this week. How was your week?
First, I'd like to apologize to our YouTube viewers. This week's show was not put on there because my week sucked, because I've been having massive internet issues at home. Hopefully it's all going to be taken care of and this show will be posted on time and whatnot. As far as the rest of the week, pretty uneventful other than the fact that my butthole cat keeps...
I thought you were going to say something else. Okay.
No. He has a new way of waking me up now, and he only does it between the hours of 3 and 4 a.m. every day. He climbs up and he just starts slapping this big mirror that's hanging on just enough that it makes noise until I get up and either throw him out of the room and close the door, or I go and feed him. And it's really, really annoying. Cat owners out there will understand.
I have my cats. I have a hallway door. They open the hallway door. You go down the hallway, and my bedroom's in there. And I have to shut that door, or the cats come in and they paw at the door. Well, the other morning I woke up at about 2:30 in the morning, 3 o'clock. It was 3 o'clock. It was the witching hour, and I wake up at 3 o'clock regardless. Okay, I don't know if there's some phenomenon behind this. They say there is, but maybe it's just a circadian rhythm or whatever it is. Anyway, I woke up at 3. And it was one of those things where you're dreaming and you can hear stuff in your dreams, and you wake up and you're like, did I really hear that? Well, what I woke up to was scratching on the door. And do you remember Taillipo? Remember that when we were kids? Taillipo, I want my Taillipo. And the thing came in and was scratching because the hunter cut the tail off. Do you remember the story?
Sure.
And
don't.
It was scratching at the door of his house. And then it was scratching in the hallway, just scratching at the foot of his bed. So I woke up, and the first thing I thought was Taillipo, and I'm like, wait a minute, this is just a dream. So I start to close my eyes, and I hear it again, and it's multiple scratches. I'm like, what in the – I ain't going to lie to you. I grabbed a pistola. I grabbed my gun because I'm like half asleep, right? I'm safe. I opened up the door, and the cats had pushed the hallway door open and got in there, and I'm like, just get in and get in bed and shut up. So anyway, we've got a lot to go over talking about Taillipo. Let me see. Oh, yeah. We're good to go here. So, the GOP had losses this week, and a lot of people freaked out and thought they were significant, but they also had some gains as well. They flipped some amazingly blue seats over. Of course, we had the Republican debates going on, which I didn't watch. I just don't see no point in watching it, but we got some highlights. We'll talk about that a little bit. Another thing that goes in with these losses and gains for the Republicans, abortion. and Ohio passed an abortion law. Israel did a is doing a 4-hour pause now, which I won't be surprised if they're getting rockets launched at them while they do this. White House was vandalized by pro-Palestinian protesters. There's more stuff going on in Ukraine, possibly with peace talks. The Nashville shooter manifesto got leaked. Did you see that?
Yeah.
And that's, I can see why they wanted to keep that under wraps. We're going to get into that as well. And the latest polls for Biden are, I didn't even know what to say. I mean, CNN, the only one was a tip poll came out that was okay for him. But CNN and the New York Times, and they're coming out with these huge gains, especially in these battleground states, for Trump. You know, I just, we've got some audio we're going to play, I think, in the next segment or the segment after. Biden is in complete denial about this. Did you hear the audio I played?
Yeah.
I mean, this is...
I don't know what world he's living in. Neither does he, to be honest with you. But...
I don't try to be, like, conspiracy theorist, but do you think that CNN and the New York Times are maybe inflating these polls to tell him to get out? Because they have always leaned to the left. And all of a sudden, you think that they would use these polls as a way to show, no, Biden's ahead. Biden's ahead. Look, Biden's doing good.
Yeah.
Maybe they want him out of there. I'm not saying that's a fact.
I'm not saying they don't want him out, because I think they probably do. But I don't think they would go so far as to inflate Trump's numbers.
I wouldn't think they would, but anyway, we're going to delve into that in the rest of the show. Excuse me, we talked about a lot of different things in the first segment. One of the issues was the Republicans had some losses this week. More specifically, I would say probably in Kentucky.
I'm a horrible American.
Why?
I completely forgot it was Election Day.
Yeah, well...
I mean, it's not a significant one.
Here's the thing, Deez. I think a lot of people forgot it was Election Day. Now, a lot of these conservatives are freaking out about this, but we had some losses, but we had a lot of gains in New York. So, do I think everybody's waking up to what's going on quite yet? No.
Were federal seats up?
State seats.
Okay.
So, anyway, we'll get into that.
So, Illinois doesn't matter,
Illinois, you still got to go and vote and try, because we inch a little bit closer and a little bit closer and a little bit closer. But anyway, I wanted to say this, though. A lot of conservatives were worked up about this, and I get it, but it's really not the end of the world. I don't think it's very telling. People read too much into this. Like I said, Nassau County, Suffolk County, New York, Republicans are pretty much in control of that now, which is telling, because I think the people in New York are getting pissed to the point to where they're fed up with crime. They're fed up with everything going on in their city. I think those people are getting to that point that we all think everybody should be to, where they just get fed up and say, we can't vote for this anymore. Now, I'm not saying that what happened in... So Daniel Cameron, who was Trump-backed and McConnell-backed, was beat by Governor Andy Beshear. 52.5 to 47.5. I think that's what the final tally was. Now, a couple things here. First of all, Kentucky's a red state, okay? Kentucky's always usually been a red state. Andy Beshear is really good at hiding what he wants to do. People in Kentucky live a lot freer than we do. I don't think people in Kentucky are as motivated as the Democrats. So this Daniel Cameron, I guess, was a big proponent of this extreme abortion bill, which is another thing we have to get into, because I think this extreme abortion stuff is going to end up killing us in some states and in some races. It already is killing us, because we don't have, A, it's too extreme, and B, we don't have a good ground game. So I think that's what happened with Daniel Cameron losing to Andy Beshear. Okay. Now, people say, well, he was Trump endorsed. Well, he was also McConnell endorsed, too.
For stupid people like me, extreme abortion meaning what?
So Cameron was, I'd have to look it up here real quick, but it was extreme abortion, extreme anti-abortion, as in, you know, only in cases of incest and rape, or even not in cases of incest and rape. Sometimes they go as far as to say, nope, the kid's having the baby anyway. That's extreme.
Okay, gotcha.
Okay? So extreme on the other end of the spectrum is abortion up until the time of birth.
Yeah.
Okay, so you get it. We're going to have to come up with something. But here's the thing. I don't think that this was necessarily telling that there's a blue wave coming or that people are not fed up. How often, well, I wouldn't say you, but I talk to a lot of people about this that'll go vote in the presidential primaries. They make that the thing, Trump, 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 or Biden, 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 got to go vote, got to go vote, got to go vote. But when it comes to these state Senate races, they forget about it. Most of these people are working. Okay, they got families to manage. They don't get to the polls. I think Kentucky turnout was down by like 4%. And that's what I think it is. And the other issue, too, with this, these couple of losses, is the Democratic Party has a great ground game. They go out there and they'll mince words and they put all this money into these advertisements that get to all these people and get these people pissed off. Some of them aren't even Democrats. Some of them are middle of the road. And they put out these ads like, little Sally was 10 and got knocked up by her stepfather and she was forced to carry the baby and that's what Republicans want. Well, of course, anybody's going to be like, I'm not going to go vote for this guy. Most of these middle of the road people. That sounds stupid. Most of the time, though, that's not the case. Most of the time, they're hiding what they want. And I have kind of changed my tune on abortion. I wouldn't say change my tune, but I've gotten to the point to where we're going to have to meet in the middle on this. I don't know if that's ever going to be possible. Okay.
But probably not in our lifetime.
I don't know, but this is, we got to stop going to extremes with this stuff. Now, like I said, Nassau County, the GOP retained its majority in the county legislature and saw Republicans in the Hempstead, North Hempstead, and Oyster Bay Town Supervisor post handily reelected. Okay. Suffolk County, 1.5 million residents there. Ed Romaine, okay, became the first Republican to win the county's executive office in 2 decades. And they got several more local seats in New York City suburbs. So there are places that are starting to flip. So I wouldn't take these handful of losses we had here as anything extreme. I just think it was bad turnout. We got to get our ground game better. And I don't think this has anything to do. I think Trump was up by like 9 points in Kentucky. And everybody goes, well, how was Trump up 9 points in Kentucky and they reelected the Democrat for governor? I'll tell you why, because people are motivated. People see Trump all the time. Trump's there. Trump's there. They do these polls. Most of the working class people are not motivated to go out and vote, especially living in a state like Kentucky. They're pretty free down there. They don't have the same issues that we have here or they have in New York. So their motivation to get out there and drop everything they're doing is not as great as it would be in cities or townships like you saw in New York City. What do you think, Deez?
Yeah, I mean, I forgot it was an election day, and I can say that I have never in my life voted a odd year election.
Yeah, see, you're part of it. I mean, you're part of that. I mean,
story of my life, man. I'm part of the problem.
No, but you're that's what, and I'm glad you did that. I'm glad you said that, because that's a perfect example of what's going on in places like Kentucky. It's not that it's going blue. It's just that people are lazy. People just, well, I wouldn't say lazy. Some people are lazy. Some people aren't. Some people are distracted. You didn't even know about it. Don't even know when they have the elections here.
To quote, no, I don't. To quote one of my favorite movies of all time, Office Space, it's not that I'm lazy, Bob. It's that I just don't care.
There you go. You just don't care. Well, that's what happens in Kentucky when you just don't care. You get more Democrats. You get more people that want to restrain you. You get more people that want to screw the state up.
Hey, Deez, heard you've been missing elections. Well, I wouldn't say I've been missing them, Bob.
So this thing in Ohio, they passed this new abortion law in Ohio that, well, it's not an abortion law. It pretty much is abortion up until the time of birth, if you read it. There's no restrictions on there. It's up to the woman. It's up to the doctor. And they
all of Ohio, just for a mental note, in case,
yes,
you know,
which is a red state, which Trump's leading in and Trump led.
In case they ever need to save me some money on child support.
Trump won it. Now, remember, historically, that was the first time in the history of the two states that the person that run Ohio and Florida didn't win the presidency. Just saying. I've talked about that before.
I thought it was the second. I thought Kennedy was the first. Didn't we talk about that before?
No, that was not the case. It was one of those states I believe he won, but that's another story altogether. I did a lot of research on this. Anyway, it was an anomaly.
Right.
Anyhow, Ohio's a red state. They believe it's lean and purple. But here's the thing. These people voted for this because it sounded good. I talked to a lot of people, okay, about abortion. And most people are pro-abortion. Well, you know, it should be a woman's right to choose. But when you put it down, right, the way these bills are written, that you can have abortion up until the time of birth, most people don't know that. Well, that's not true. Yeah, it says right here. There is no guidelines on when you cannot have an abortion. It didn't say 15 weeks. It didn't say 20 weeks. It says it's up to the woman to do it. And in cases of rape, incest, the life of the mother, or the health of the mother. So all it takes, the health of the mother, the mental health of the mother. So she's got, I heard one pundit say, well, she's got migraines, so cut the kid out of her at 9 months. Now, I'm not saying that's happening in all cases, but that's that extremist point, and that's how they write these things. Most people that voted for this in Ohio didn't know what they were voting for. Okay? They did not know what they were voting for. That's why people have to educate themselves and get out there and really look at things, because they'll dress that up in different mannerisms and they'll put lipstick on the pig until it looks pretty. I mean, that's what they've always done. That's how they get people to vote for these things. That's how you get these Democrats elected. Most of the people that voted for Joe Biden, I mean, they say 81 million people. I don't think it was 81 million people. What do you think? I still don't buy it. We've got stuff coming out in Pennsylvania that the machines were flipping votes. Oh, that was human error. Somebody put it in there to flip the vote. We'll talk about that coming up, too.
There's, I guess, more issues in good old Maricopa County also. Mm.
Pull that story up. We'll get to that as well. Yeah. We're finishing up this segment. But the only point is I wanted to make on this particular subject was, I was going back to Biden. Sorry, I kind of stumbled there a bit. There's a lot of people that voted for Joe Biden that aren't diehard liberals, okay? They just thought he was centrist. They saw what happened with Trump. They didn't pay a lot of attention to what was going on. They just thought it was chaos and thought, hey, we'll vote for this guy. He can't be that bad. I think a lot of people regret that now. And we'll get into the next segment, the poll numbers as well with that, which are demonstrably horrible for Joe Biden. A lot of people are starting to wake up. So don't fret this Kentucky thing. We kept a lot of seats. Kentucky looked bad. I get it, but don't fret about it. Like I said, we talked about New York and what was going on there. But we'll also have some poll numbers, and I'm going to show you why this has nothing to do with Donald Trump and why nobody should be afraid that, well, Donald Trump-backed candidates are losing, so Donald Trump can't do it. That's bull sticks. If you look at how many people tuned into the Republican debate, which has got to be, we should pull those numbers up for the next segment. Can you look into that, what the viewership was for that? Exactly.
I can try.
Yeah, you can. Oh, try nothing. You'll just do it. There is no try. There's only do here on the Aldonzo and D Show. So we're coming up. We're going to take a quick break.
If you're going to quote Star Wars, quote it right.
I wasn't quoting Star Wars. I'm not a dork.
Kind of were.
No, I wasn't. Anyway, we're going to argue about Star Wars. We'll be right back here on Cities 92.9, the news and talk of Bloomington Normal. Now, we were talking about some of the losses in games in the last segment, and I'll give you an example right now of how this kind of leads to pandemonium here. You get Iowa Governor Kim Reynolds. It's just a headline from Fox News. Endorses Ron DeSantis for president. Says she doesn't think Trump can win in 2024. Well, I got a question. When you look at the poll numbers, Ron DeSantis is so far behind. You got the debate stuff, right? The Republican debates. And we said this before. I didn't even watch it. We got some highlights from it. I know that Nikki Haley referred to Vivek Ramaswamy as scum after he called her daughter out for using TikTok, and she wants to ban TikTok and got on him because he had a TikTok account.
And he called her Dick Cheney in 3-inch heels.
Oh, and she said, no, it's 5-inch heels, didn't she? Yeah, something about whatever. Look, farts in the wind is what I see when I see clips of that debate stage. All these people fighting for second place, they're not even close. If I'm telling you right now, I would be concerned if the poll numbers show Trump, you know, edging out Ron DeSantis by 3 points. Okay, maybe the American people really, you know, might not want Trump. You know, or if Ron DeSantis was, you know, handily beating Joe Biden in these polls and Trump was only tied with him, maybe that's showing us something. That's not the case. So I have no desire to watch the Republican debates. It's a waste of time. It's not even close. I don't know what could happen to give Ron DeSantis or Nikki Haley or Chris Christie a push. It'd probably be a bulldozer to give him a push. He needs to practice pushaways is what he needs to do. I'm always going to have to Chris Christie for that. You weren't even paying attention, were you?
Could happen is Trump goes to prison and they find some obscure way to keep him off the ballots, and don't underestimate their ability or want to do that either.
Well, I'm going to tell you something.
If we have an election at all.
I agree with that. We can talk about that. I don't know what they're going to do with Biden. Biden's in complete denial about this. Let's see. I think Biden was talking to Peter Doocy. Peter Doocy had some questions for him. Biden is in complete denial, and we'll go over after we play this clip for you. We will go after the polls and where everybody's resting right now. Let's see if we can get this clip. Now, I had to do some audio magic on this to get it right, so I hope this sounds good. But this is Peter Doocy grilling Joe Biden about his polling, and shouldn't he be concerned about this? Let's go ahead and pull this up right now. I think this happened a couple days ago. Here we go. Roll clip.
Why do you think it is that people should be more concerned about abortion access than your age?
I don't think it's a comparable comparison.
Why do you think it is that you're trailing Trump in all these swing state polls?
Because you don't read the polls. There are 10 polls. 8 of them, I'm beating them in those states. 8 of them. You guys only do 2. CNN and New York Times. Check it out. We'll get you a copy of all those other polls.
You don't believe you're trailing in battleground states?
No, I don't.
Now, he must not have access to real clear politics, Deez, but we do, don't we?
Yeah, well, he is not national polls. He's specifically. That's it. Talking about battleground states.
Okay, well, how about this? Is Georgia battleground state? Just came out today. This is Friday. We pre-taped. That was Thursday he said that. Friday, Georgia, Trump versus Biden. Trump 48, Biden 41. Pennsylvania, Trump versus Biden. Trump 47, Biden 44. Now, here's one for you. Pennsylvania, Trump versus Biden versus Kennedy versus Cornell West. Trump's leading by 3 points. What about this? Wisconsin. This is another Bloomberg. Biden 46, Trump 47. Trump was actually below that in the recent poll, so he's actually leading there. Nevada, Trump versus Biden. Trump 46, Biden 43. Ohio, Trump versus Biden. Trump 51, Biden 43. Okay? General election. Trump is beating him in almost everything. All these polls. I have to go back a little bit farther here. The big one, CNN polls. This was from Wednesday. General election. This is CNN poll. Trump 49, Biden 45. General election, DeSantis versus Biden. Biden 46, DeSantis 48. So even DeSantis is beating him. My point is, when you look at these polls, all of them, and I don't like trust in polls, but this is a stark difference from where we were in 2016 and 2020. I think people are fed up. It's kind of like, you ever break up with a girl because she was crazy?
Is there any other reason?
Is there any other answer? Or you had a long-term relationship with somebody and you end it, and then you start thinking, well, you know, and then you get together with another crazy woman, and you're like, well, that so-and-so really wasn't that bad. I think a lot of people are starting to remember right now just how good they had it with Trump, and this is why Trump will handily get the nomination, and this is why Trump will beat Biden if there's a 24 election between him and Biden, okay? And this is why he'd even beat, let's say, If they drop Biden and put Michelle Obama in there, I think he's got a chance.
I don't think it's going to be Obama.
I think
choice two is Newsom.
This is unprecedented. Well, it's not unprecedented. I think this happened once, but in the past, I think it's 100 years. So we have a candidate right now that already had 4 years in, and everybody remembers what it was like under the Trump administration. We could afford gas. Jobs were plentiful. Everybody was making money. It almost seems like there's no light at the end of the tunnel.
There isn't.
What he has over everybody else is a track record. Everybody can vote for him going, okay, I know what it was like under Trump. At least we know. Even if you don't like Trump, that's an evil that you know. You know he will make things better and do everything in his power to do it. We were talking in the cold open about all these people pouring across the border. Well, we didn't talk about it in the cold open, but we referenced it with Hamas. And these sleeper cells and this wide open border that everybody's coming across. That didn't happen with Trump. We didn't have these wars with Trump. Nobody would do this while Donald Trump was president. So I think, yeah, absolutely. I don't think these polls are bull sticks. I don't. I think they're real. I think people are pissed off and you're starting to see it. Now, if we can only get these people motivated on a local scale, I think we could absolutely flip everything around. Deez, what do you think?
It's a nice thought, but I mean, I don't see it happening as far as flipping everything. Trump, yeah, I think that he's got a very strong chance if A, there's an election, and B, they don't find some way to railroad him off the ballot. But as far as like the places, i.e. Illinois, that are what they are, I don't know that I could see that proverbial light
with,
at the
with
end of the
time term. With time, maybe. Okay, now let's say we do have that election, okay, and let's say Trump is in jail. I think he's the only person that could get elected president by being in jail. Check this out. CNN poll: Donald Trump beats Joe Biden among men of color 49-46%. D's.
Oh yeah,
this is unprecedented. They said that his support amongst men of color and African Americans actually skyrocketed after his
mugshot. Yeah,
I'm telling you right now, I would not, and that's the thing, we're coming up on the end of the segment. What the hell do you think they're going to do to keep Trump from winning? How far are they going to go? We've talked about this before. This is getting down to, they're going to have to get Joe Biden out of there. Okay, if they are going to have an election in 2024, they got to replace Biden.
Yeah, and now, I think they will.
Now, here's a problem. If they replace Biden, they got to replace Kamala Harris too. Because Harris is even worse than Biden. If you look at the polls, if Harris was president, it's no contest.
Yeah.
I think Chris Christie was beating her in a poll, which all he'd have to do to beat her is roll over and he'd have her. You know, Chris Christie. What? He calling out
Why
Trump.
Why is he still on the stage?
I don't know. Like, he just won't go away. He's like a bad dream, a bad smell in your house. Christie reminds me of, like, makes me think of, like, if a raccoon got in your house and crawled into the ductwork and died, and you just had to keep smelling it, and there's nothing you could do about it. You couldn't get away from it.
Didn't Tim Scott pull out as well?
Yes, but Scott was back in there through.
Say, why the hell was he on the debate then?
I'll have to. Let's get that on the next segment. I may be mixed up on that.
I could have swore I read that he.
I did too. Let's instead of speculation,
his campaign and put his support behind Trump.
Instead of speculation, let's get our facts together here during the break.
We don't need no stinking facts.
We don't need no stinking facts. We just wing it here on the El Donzo and D Show. And you completely threw me off my tangent I was going for. But here's the thing. I think whoever they replace, if they do it, if we do have an election, they're going to have to replace him. I agree with a lot of the pundits out there. Michelle Obama is the dead ringer to come in and replace him. That has to be a woman, and it has to be a woman of color, especially if they take Kamala Toe Harris out of there, because they're going to lose so much support. They got to get the black support. This is bad for them. This is a nightmare what's going on right now. And you've got all these talking heads and these Democrats coming out and sounding the alarm on it. They are freaking out. James Carville made a good point. He's like, there's nothing, you got to fess up to this. It's not bedwetting. This is bad. They're going to hand it over to Trump. So I think Michelle Obama, who you thought Gavin Newsom, didn't you?
Yeah.
A nice, perfectly clean
I could see a Newsom-Obama ticket.
A lot of people could. That's a lot of people could. I've heard other people say that as well. Hey, welcome back to the El Donzo and D Show here on Cities 92.9, the news and talk of Bloomington Normal. Now, Deez, you had a term for what just happened on the last segment. What was that? The Mandela effect.
Yeah, that's where, you know, you are absolutely certain you remembered something one way, but it in fact was something different. And yeah, we were referring to an article that both of us saw talking about Rick Scott, not Tim Scott.
Yes, Rick Scott, the senator. Rick Scott, the senator Trump. From Florida.
Tim Scott is still very much in the race, although he's not in the race.
And I boned that up last week. I was talking about Rick Scott and said Tim Scott, which it happens.
Speaking of boning things up, did you see Tim Scott's girlfriend on stage?
Yeah, I did. She's
nice pole, buddy.
Good looking woman she is. Yeah. But no, that kind of confused. I'm like, well, wait a minute. Didn't we read this? But yeah, the Mandela effect. That's why we had to go to break. I'm like, wait a minute. This can't be.
Where's all the white women?
And we won't dance with your dates. So anyway, we got that straightened out, thankfully. I'll never hear the end about that one. You know who. I'm not going to mention her name, but I know I'm going to hear about it.
Ooh, I know.
What? Oh, don't say it. She doesn't like it when I mention it.
Yeah.
Whoa, that was weird, wasn't it? Hey, we're still going, though. That's all right on the Aldonzo and D show. Fake it till you make it right here. All right, so something I want to talk about real quick. Group of left-wing pro-Palestinian protesters, you hear about this. They went and vandalized the White House last Saturday night.
No, I didn't.
Oh, yeah. They threw paint on it. They're shaking the gates. They were shouting, F Joe Biden, and here's the thing.
Threw paint on what? The fence?
Yeah.
Oh, you really got us.
Well, they were shouting Allahu Akbar, too. Which, what is wrong with them? And there are probably some stupid little white kids as well, some little privileged, getting into privileged little white kids. We're going to talk about the Nashville School Shooters Manifesto that came out this week, too. But I got a question for you. Shouting Allahu Akbar? That's what terrorists say before they blow themselves up or kill a bunch of people. God is great. These people are... Society is going to collapse. This is a level of brainwashed I would never imagine I'd ever seen in my life. Allahu Akbar? Does nobody know what the hell that means? That's what they said before they flew the terrorists said before they flew the planes into the Twin Towers. Allahu Akbar. This is sickening.
Now, you say that in the wrong neighborhood, you're liable to catch a couple slugs.
Well, yeah, especially around here, right? That's my biggest fear is at this point going into a Walmart and hearing Allahu Akbar. Oh, damn it. I mean, I don't know, I almost expected at this point. I got a question. These people that were, I mean, when they're defacing the White House, do you think that the FBI is going to track them down for years and then kick in their door at 4 a.m. and drag them out at gunpoint because they were there or anybody that was walking around the area? Probably not.
I doubt it.
Yeah. Why would they do that? They're also, the Capitol Police also nabbed a guy, this just a couple days ago, carrying a long gun near the Capitol. Look at this dude, and he looks disheveled. He looked like he was hiding in the weeds. I haven't heard anything else on this yet, but you can't even have a gun near the Capitol. It's not like you can have a long gun, you know, if you keep it near. I don't even think you can have a gun, period, there. So anyway, a lot of weird stuff going on. Something's going to break here pretty soon, folks. Let's see how much time we got. I want to get into something else. Yeah, we got plenty of time.
Real quick, even though you'll hear this after the fact, happy Veterans Day to all you vets out there, and happy birthday, Marine Corps.
Yes, Semper Fi. Yes, thank you for bringing that up. And remember, don't ever refer to a Marine as an ex-Marine or said somebody was a Marine. Once a Marine, always a Marine. Okay? I've seen posts on there. Hey, you know, want to say happy birthday to the Marine Corps and to all the Marines or people that were Marines. No, they're always Marines.
And I feel like I do this every year, but let's also keep in mind that Veterans Day are for those that are still with us who served. Memorial Day are for those that are no longer with us. So pay respects to the right group of people.
I mean, even if you mix it up, that's okay. I mean, we get it, the heart's in the right spot, but yeah. I mean, just little tidbits Aldonzo and D's want you to remember there. But anyway, okay, so I wanted to get to this. The Department of Health and Human Services, they just rolled out this new pronoun policy, okay? And a couple of people are saying this is illegal. HHS and federal government is requiring its employees to speak falsehoods. Roger Severino, the Heritage Foundation's vice president for domestic policy and the former head of civil rights at HHS during the Trump administration, told Fox News Digital. I guess what they're doing now is they're saying that you have to address people by their preferred pronouns, and if you misgender them, you will be fired. So if D's and I are working at HHS, and D said he's a woman, he identifies as a woman, I said, hey, dude, I could be fired for that.
Stop the world. I want to get off.
I mean, it's all make them up. We were talking about the black Hebrew Israelites and the pro-Palestinians, the black Muslims rioting last week. I mean, this is all make them up stuff. I mean, to the point to where if you speak the truth, you could be fired. That's the truth. Look at this guy. What's this guy's name? Yeah, oh yeah, Rachel Levin, Richard Levin. He's a dude. So if
it's
I work
a man,
there,
baby.
He's a man, baby. Banana, nana, dude look like a lady. No, this dude does not look like a lady.
No.
He had it wrong there. All right, so that's one thing I wanted to get to. Just the world's imploding at this point. Okay, also, we talked about this. Okay, voting machines are down in several districts in Pennsylvania due to votes getting flipped. All right, of course, the Gateway Pundit is leading off on this. Voting machines went down in Palmer Township, Bethany Wesleyan Church in Lehigh Township, College Hill Presbyterian Church in Easton, and at the Allen Township Fire Hall. The voting machines only flip votes in the retention race between Judge Jack Pinella and Judge Victor Stable for the Pennsylvania Supreme Court. Now, this press conference, this election official stated, it appears that when a voter selects a yes or a no for one of the candidates for retention to the Pennsylvania Superior Court, the selection is recorded on the paper ballot and on the machine for the other candidate. The issue is limited to the retention of the Supreme Court judge and is also an issue when recording the votes for when a voter selected a yes for one candidate and a no for another candidate. They said this was human error. Somebody put it in wrong. Well, I got a question. How many times has this happened before?
Right.
Now, if you want to go back, they're trying to hold Trump accountable for saying that the election was rigged. Trump's major defense here, and all their defenses, is look at what's going on. We didn't have a right to question this. This absolutely, stuff like this is why we should be able to question it. Stuff like this is why they wanted to stop certification.
Or the case in Connecticut, where they proved there was voter fraud.
Yes, we'll bring that up on the next segment. We're coming into hour two here on the Aldonzo and D Show on Cities 92.9, the news and talk, Bloomington Normal.